Just one moment, please. Mr. Chairperson, distinguished guests, thank you very much for attending our presentation today. I am Warasuong Dongchinda, and
my name is Nitsa Chamayon. We are from Office of Education, Online Education, Sri Pathum University.
Okay. Today our presentation topic is towards the e-learning excellence, learner satisfaction of the new e-learning system at Sri Pathum University in Thailand. We come up with this topic because of the award that we received last year from the Ministry of Education, which is the National Best Practice in E-Learning Management. So once we receive that award, we need to prove that what we are doing is in the right way. So today, we are presenting a basic research just to confirm that our e-learning system can satisfy the users. So please allow me to start. เข้าเน็ตได้ไหมครับดูเปิดดูซิเขาเน็ตให้ผมก็ได้ขอบคุณครับ Okay, start again. Okay, today the topic of our talk is towards the e-learning excellence, learner satisfaction of the new e-learning system at Sri Pathum University of Thailand. And if you would like to have a copy of our presentation, it is available online right now, gwo.gl/glk-bigl-k. gwo.gl/glk-bigl-k. Or if you have a QR code scanner, please feel free to scan. Okay. This is us. Warasuong is me, and this is Nitsa from the Office of Online Education, Sri Pathum University. And this is the content of our talk. We will start with the introduction to Office of Online Education, which is our office at Sri Pathum University. Then we would like to talk about the website that we will evaluate. And lastly, we will discuss about the research findings and so on. Okay, now let's move to the first part, introduction to the Office of Online Education at Sri Pathum University. First of all, we call ourselves OOE, Office of Online Education. We are actually at the Sri Pathum University main campus in Bang Khien, Bangkok. The university has set up our office to be the main body looking after the e-learning in all levels at the university. So starting from how to generate with an idea to make an e-learning classes, or how to really make a fully online classes. That is the basic of our office. And then this is our mission. We help the university to have well-structured e-learning infrastructure. We have our e-learning production unit. We provide support for educational technology. We provide support in terms of human resource development for everything related to e-learning, and lastly, we also do the research related to the e-learning. And with that, we also have 6 points as a main policy. First, we provide support for everyone at the university for e-learning. Second, we promote the use of e-learning at all levels. Third, we provide service to help everyone at the university, including students and professors, to teach or to study online. We carry on the traditional educational mode as well, but use ICT and e-learning as a guide, help for better teaching and learning. We develop e-learning courses for the university. And lastly, we also have the quality assurance to make sure that whatever we do is correct. And this is the identity of our office. We have this term that we proud of, which is victory. The V is vision. We work with the vision. We know what is going to happen in the near future. We work with intelligence. We work with cheerfulness. We are technologically advanced. We are outstanding of the things we do. We have respect to everyone concerned within our team and to other teams. And the last one, why? It is, yes, we can. We can do everything that we would like to do if it is good. And this is when president of our university received the best award for best practice in e-learning management at higher education level last year in September. So this is a milestone. We actually become a project on the 1st of February last year, and then we become a real office on the June 7th last year. On September 8th last year, we won the National Best Practice for Online Education Management by the MOE. And today, June 14, 2012, we're presenting a small research that we do. Now, let me move to the second part of our presentation, which is about the website that we provide for Sibutum University. The web address is elearning.spu.ac.th. Once again, elearning.spu.ac.th. And you can spell e-learning in any way that you like, E-L or big E, big L, up to you. It will take you to the same place. And this is the look of the website, which is a Moodle. We use Moodle version 1.99. We haven't upgraded it to version 2.x yet because we also have some other system link together. So upgrading is a big task, and we are looking into that. But right now, it is Moodle 1.99. Okay, coming into the third part of our presentation, which is about the study that we do. We would like to explain to you about the research, the findings, and the discussion. First, the objective of our survey is, first, we would like to measure user satisfaction of the e-learning system. Second, we would like to have guidelines for future development, so two clear objectives. Now, the research boundary. The population of the research is the students at undergraduate level in the academic year 2011. Sample size that we got is 709 students, and we collect the data between March and May this year. The tool, we use a very simple tool, which is survey form, a printed version, only one page long. Okay, now please allow me to take you to the working process, how we develop the survey and how we deploy them. First, we gather the questions from literature review. We check across many literatures to make sure that the questions we are going to ask is right. Then we divide the question into three groups. The first one is about demographic. Second one is about the satisfaction. And the last one is expectation for future services. And we use normal questions plus Likert scale. Then we verify and validate the survey with three experts in the educational technology area. After the form is validated, then we distribute in printed version to about 1,000 students. And as I mentioned before, 709 students returned the form, which is about 70.9%. And we use a random distribution method on the busy days, let's say maybe Tuesday or Thursday, where students come to university most. So I would like to take you to this part, result analysis. We for the first part, demographic, we use frequency and percentage to measure the information. For the part two, satisfaction, we use mean and standard deviation to analyze the data. And lastly, for the expectation for future services, we use mean and standard deviation also. So as you can see, this is quite a basic research. We are not talking about complex high level of stat. We just would like to make sure that whatever we do is simply in the right direction. Now, the finding. First, about user satisfaction of the overall system, we can find that the students are very satisfied with our system. Second, about the service provided on the website, we can also conclude that the students are very satisfied with the service provided. About system overall, when I say system overall, it means from the look and feel of the website, after they log in, when they're using the website, when they're browsing the content, and when they log out, so they give us the system overall rating as very satisfied. And lastly, when we talk about future expectation, whether or not they believe that our system is good enough and then there are going to be many more good things coming, they said they are very satisfied with everything and they believe that our system would take them to another step of education. So basically everything is satisfied. And in conclusion, I would like to jump to the conclusion because I know you are tired and want to go home. First, the survey reveals that we are on the right track, but still we admit that this is just an early stage. Although last year we won the national best practice for e-learning management, but that is the process. We also to make sure that outcome of the process is right. So that will be our next step of research. Let's say, for example, we have some programs that we are going to offer in the blended learning mode degree program. We will have a more in-depth research for that, and Khun Nisha will help me for that part, and hopefully we can come back to present next year. And this is the faces of the team, Office of Online Education at Sri Pathum University. Thank you very much everyone for being a good audience today. I give you like and plus one. Thank you very much, and if you have questions, please feel free to ask me now, or if you would like to talk more or would like to give us some advice, don't be afraid. This is my address at Warasuang. You can add me on the Facebook and just talk to me over there. So thank you very much for listening to us. Thank you. ขอบคุณครับ.
That was so fast. Any questions?
Okay, yes. Please. And Khun Nisha will give you the answer.
Thank you for the excellent presentation. I know this question might sound a little bit silly. What's the total population at your school, and are you considering to open this online education to any of the international students in the future? Thank you.
Khun Nisha passes the microphone to me. First question, how many students in total? Across the all programs at Sri Pathum University Bang Khien campus, we have about 13,000 students enrolled. Okay, but if we talk about only undergraduate level, we have about 10,000 students. So this is 1 in 10. And second, whether or not we are going to offer online education to overseas students, Of course, yes. At the moment, we are partnering with overseas institutions such as Consortium of Global Education, CGE. And doing that, we are going to offer online programs using Moodle to students across the globe, not only students in Thailand, but I'm talking about students in Middle East, in USA, in Africa, and in Australia continent. So we are working on that. Thank you. Very good question. Thank you.
One more question.
As a director of OOE, can you please share your vision toward the future of e-learning at Sibutum with us?
Okay. Thank you very much for the question. As the director of the office, I have the vision that we alone, we will never make proper e-learning. I always maintain my thought that we have to collaborate and co-create e-learning contents, process, teaching and learning for better outcome. This morning, we already listened to speakers mentioning about the concept of OER, Open Educational Resources. I think that is the direction that we will look into. And if we can, let's say Thailand, not only Sibutum University, but say Chulalongkorn University, co-develop e-learning content in the better way. First, we don't need to compete because making e-learning content often costs a lot of money. Second, we might not have enough expertise to make e-learning content in all areas. So by combining together and working together, we could have national OER suitable for all the universities, but the process of teaching and learning will depend on each of us. We might have the same book, but the way to teach the book is up to us. So that is my vision, and I think I share the vision with you. Thank you.